On today, folks, I hope everyone is doing well. It is a very gloomy day here in central Minnesota. It's overcast, it's raining, it's not a very upbeat and exciting day. So today, even though it's gloomy and overcast, we are going to do our best to create some content. Today's topic is HomeAdvisor. A lot of people were giving me duff about it. A lot of people know that I've used it. I've had a lot of questions about it. Recently, a thing came out on ABC News that HomeAdvisor was a scam. A bunch of contractors were griping about it and complaining about it. And my first red flag was that it's from ABC News. Do you believe anything you hear or see on ABC News? Because I know I don't. NBC, XYZ, news media is it's a crock, if you ask me. Many people sent to me that ABC did a big complaint about a bunch of people whining about HomeAdvisor. So I'm just going to give you my honest opinion on it. A lot of people hate it. A lot of people tell me I shouldn't use it. A lot of people say it's a scam. And I'm just going to tell you what my experience is with it. So, 2017. I was 17 years old. I'd been done landscaping, excavating. Drove trucks like this. Drove skid loaders like that my whole life. That's what I grew up doing. That's what I love to do. I worked for a small local company for a short time. I worked for a big commercial landscape company for a year. Did everything I could do there. I swept the parking lot, I mowed the grass, I did landscaping, I worked in the nursery, I worked in the heel, I did everything I could do there. Just everything other than the irrigation pretty much in 1 year. And I tried to be the best employee they ever had. I don't know if I was or wasn't, but that's what I was trying to do. So what I did then was I was 16 years old. I got my license 2 days after I turned 16. And I started there. I went and applied like 2 days after I got my license. So my birthday's March 1st. Got my license like March 3rd. Went and applied there like March 5th or 6th. Got hired. I worked there an entire year. I made about $17,000 total. I was living at home, of course. I was 16 years old. Made $17,000. I saved about $10,000, $11,000. And then I spent $5,000 on something I'm gonna make a video here shortly. I had about $5,000 left. And I went and wanted to start a business. So I started with about $4,000 or $5,000. And I bought a truck, bought a trailer, had zero work, had no leads, had no connections, nothing. Well, I had a small connection or two, but none that were really producing any amount of work. So I need some work. Oh, I heard about this thing called HomeAdvisor. I looked into it. It was $500 to sign up for a year, and then every lead was X amount. At the time, I'd bought a truck, bought a trailer. I didn't have $500. So I didn't have $500. So I had a credit card, though. I'm like, oh, I'll give it a whirl. I'll put this $500 on a credit card. Maybe it's not the brightest thing to do, but I need some work. So through HomeAdvisor and credit card, $500, started getting leads. Right away, leads started coming in, and people looking for small landscape jobs, $1,000 to $7,000 landscape jobs. And right away, it was instant. I instantly had work. I instantly had leads coming in. And it's really what blew me up. So I started in like July on my own 2017, when it was just me. I was 17 years old, had a truck and a trailer. Actually, this trailer right here, I did like a contract for a deed with a local guy. A local guy was willing to work with me on it. And so I started with that. And right away I had work coming in. I was 17 years old. My parents told me something I'll never forget. My mom literally told me one day, Garrett, who in the world is gonna hire a 17 year old? I'm like, well, I don't go up to people and tell them, hey, I'm 17, hire me to do your job. It's like, no, it's like I went out there and just looked at what they needed to get done, and I was able to, explain the process on how I would do it, and it's gonna be this much, and I can start this time, and so on and so forth, and I started getting work. So I would say for the first year of starting out, we probably wouldn't be where we are now without HomeAdvisor. Yes, we spent a lot of money there, but you gotta do what you gotta do to get work. Starting out, you have no work, you've gotta do something to get work. Yes, it's expensive, but if you're afraid to spend $20 to get someone's contact information and turn that into a $10,000 job, I mean, it ain't gonna work. Just tell you straight up, it ain't gonna work. No matter what, you've gotta get leads. So it was instant work. It was expensive, but it was instant work. That's what it takes. Now, I still have customers from 2017. We've had them since. Snow removal customers, people that call us up every year to do landscaping, to redo this, to fix that, to tear out old landscaping, put it new, put it in a patio, plow the driveway. Like I've built a huge clientele just off HomeAdvisor for that 1 year. I used it about a year for the first year I started, roughly. And it was crazy. Like I paid $40 for a lead, and we did a $30,000 job for the guy last year. We did $30,000 in landscaping, and someone's griping about paying $20, $30, $40, $50 for a lead. Leads vary from like $13 to $80. Worth every penny of it. If you're afraid to spend $50 to get a $30,000 job, I mean, you're you need to retrain your thoughts. You gotta, you know, spend some money somewhere else, but you gotta spend money on marketing if you wanna grow. If you wanna start a new division and you don't have a bunch of work for that division yet, you can put anything you want in HomeAdvisor and get leads specifically for that. So we're starting a lawn maintenance division. We want a bunch of commercial customers, we can put in commercial lawn maintenance and boom, 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 get immediate leads for that. I mean, it's, sure, it might pay $40, but that could be a 15-year customer. The connections are huge. The people you're gonna meet through there is incredible. I bid $40,000-$50,000 jobs through HomeAdvisor, never got any of them, probably because I wasn't even qualified to even do the job at the time, but like it's huge. You never know who you're gonna meet through there. Every single person you meet through there knows another 250 people. Every single person you meet, that, like, it's so honest, it's a huge snowball. You gotta start to snowball. If you wanna start to ball rolling and getting to know people, getting repeat customers, you've got to get out and meet people. HomeAdvisor is an awesome way to do it. We didn't use it much last year at all. We already had so many repeat customers, so many referrals from previous customers that we haven't really needed to use it, but starting out, I would 100% recommend HomeAdvisor. Part of what really got us going. So yeah, that's my take on HomeAdvisor. If you need immediate work, it's right there. And here's the biggest thing where guys screw up. It's a tool, and if you don't know how to use a tool, it's gonna be a piece of junk. Someone that doesn't know how to run this brand new $60,000 machine, they're saying, "Oh, this thing's a piece of junk. It doesn't do anything." No, you don't know how to use it. You've got to know how to use a tool. And the biggest thing I found with that was people be out working in the field, they get a lead, and they would just blow it off. Be like, "Oh, I'll call later," whatever. No, you have to call them immediately. The second you get the lead, you drop what you're doing, you call them. You set up a time where you can meet with them right away, as soon as they can. And you get out there and you give them a quote. And when you go out there and meet them, you either give them a quote on site or you give it to them within, like, I try to do it within like 12 hours, 24 hours max. Because guys that put it off and call them 3 days later, well, they've already hired someone else. When a customer goes in and puts that in HomeAdvisor, they're looking for a quote now. They're not looking for a quote in 3 weeks, they're looking for a quote now. So you need to get them a quote now and get the job signed and sealed before anyone else even gets out there. So that's the key to success on HomeAdvisor, is get out there, get them a quote immediately, and you can get a ton of work from it. Yes, occasionally people don't answer the phone. I email them, I call them 3-4 times, don't get a hold of them, okay? Yeah, maybe people say, "Oh, there's fake leads." Very few. Occasionally someone doesn't answer, but you can request, if you call them several times, make several attempts to get a hold of them and you can't, you can get the lead feedback. I just got a lead a couple days ago. I called the guy 3-4 times, emailed them, never got a response. Hit request lead back, $80 lead, got it back right away, no problem. So yes, you are gonna spend some money, but you're gonna get an insane amount of work from it. And every single customer that you meet, you do a good job, they give you a review, they tell their neighbor, and then that person tells another 250 people. Like, you can make one connection and it can be worth $50,000. So if you're afraid to spend $30 on someone's info to get a $50,000, it might be $500, it could be $50,000, it could be $100,000 worth of work, it's a no-brainer for me. It really helped blow us up. If I was starting over again, I would absolutely use it again. And yes, not all leads are perfect, but same with anything. So, well, not every referral is perfect. Not every someone telling a neighbor, not that customer might not be perfect. You know that not every lead is perfect. So, quick overview. It's expensive. It works very well. I would definitely use it again. I would definitely recommend it if you're just starting out. The key is you need to be on it immediately. You hop on, you get that lead, you call them immediately. You don't wait around 2 hours, 3 hours, 2 days. A guy like me has already got in there and got the job before you even make the first call. It's too late. You lost out. So then you're going to think it's junk. I'd say it's one of those tools that, and I've been guilty of that, if it's one of those tools that if you don't know how to use it, you think it's junk when you have no idea what it's capable of because you just don't know how to use it. I think this gimbal I'm holding right now, I had no idea how to use it. I've never knew what a gimbal was until a bunch of people commented it on one of my videos. Like, "Hey Garrett, you should get a gimbal." I'm like, "What's a gimbal?" When I got this thing, it was flopping all over the place and I had no idea how to use it. I thought, "What's this thing gonna do?" Once I figured it out, I played around with it for a little bit, watched a couple videos, now I got it figured out, and now I don't like filming without it. So. It's a very useful tool. You just have to know how to use it. And if you're not using it right, it's gonna cost you a bunch of money. There's so many people that just hate it, and it's because they don't know how to use it. They're unaware of what it's capable of, and that's fine. They can, whatever, different strokes for different folks, but it works great for me, and that's why. Get on leads immediately, get out there, sell them, and you have great customer service, you do great quality work. They're gonna keep coming back to you. They're gonna tell their neighbors. It's like one connection can make so much. So I'm 100% good with paying $30 to get someone's info. That's gonna lead to, could be a lifelong relationship with them. So it's very well worth it. And every person that goes on HomeAdvisor seems like it's free for them. So most of them are, they're actively looking for a quote. Like, yeah, that's another thing. You get them on the phone, pre-qualify them. looking for a quote now. It's not something that they're looking to do in 2 years. Usually it's something they want now. So it's, they're actively looking, and it's a good client to have. So, all right, thanks so much for sticking to the end of this one with me, guys. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you want to see in the future. Spring is coming. There's a lot going on. So if you would, I'd appreciate it if you'd share this video. And remember, in order to get results no one else is getting, you must do things that no one else is doing. Straight up. If you're doing what you see everyone else doing, you're gonna get the exact same results. So go do things that other people aren't doing, and you'll start getting results that other people aren't getting. So, all right. Remember, and also another quick tip, everything in your situation that you're in today is probably because of decisions you made a year ago. So make decisions today that will put you in a better place in year 2, 3, 4, 5 years from now. All right, peace.